I can make a difference in getting support for other people who have this unpredictable, vicious, but you can learn to live with it, disease.
Who are you?
My name's Marilyn Wilson Moore. I'm Shema Moore's mother.
She's Shema's mother. I brought you in this world. And if you don't take me on a red carpet so I can be fabulous, I will take you out.
That is not true.
You're a good actor and everything, but where's my makeup? Where's my fan? I want my close-up. I got to have MS to be somebody? I mean, what is going on?
It's so important that you have a great voice. You're using your voice for this cause. What is one of the most important thing you learned from your mom going through what she's been going through?
I've learned so much from my mother just through my whole life, and that's, you know, and I'm winning an award. That's just weird to me. So I'm humbled and I'm grateful, but I don't feel like I necessarily deserve an award because all I'm doing is loving my mom. And you know, this is my superwoman. I say it all the time, whether the cameras are on or not, she is. I tell her, you know, she'll say I was in the front of the line when they were handing out kids, and I say, well, I cut the line to get to you. You know, so, you know, tonight is a humbling evening, but I don't have MS. She does. And she's one of the strongest women I've ever known before MS and even after MS. I say MS is her kryptonite. And, you know, she's my superwoman. This is her kryptonite. So she's a little cracked, but she'll never break because she's too proud and too strong. You see her over here. The smile isn't fake, you know.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you. The smile isn't fake. And so, you know, just trying to support her. I'm still learning. I'm still learning about this stupid, weird disease, and it affects people differently. And it's not just my mom. In supporting my mom, I've learned that 250,000 people a year, millions of people around the world are inflicted with this disease, and they're beating it, and they're surviving it, they're fighting it. So to win an award for something that I don't have to deal with every day, but I'm in a blessed position to where I can spread awareness and education. And as I'm learning, I hope people want to learn. And as much as I want to give her a hug, I know that by the way she stands for herself and what I'm doing is telling people out there that aren't in front of the cameras and under the lights that someone's fighting for you, not just me, doctors. I'm not a doctor. I can't cure it, but I can help the doctors keep working their magic. And my biggest dream, I'm a successful actor. Okay, great, but that's nothing as far as in my lifetime, if I can look her in the eye in her lifetime and say, hey, we beat this thing, and her and millions of other people are going to be able to never see this happen to their family members and enjoy their life the way they deserve to have a chance to enjoy it.
Well, you have an amazing son. So before we let you leave the carpet, can you share some words of advice to people that are going through what you are going through and handling it so beautifully?
I think the most important thing is to take care of your body, whatever is functioning. Like, for example, in water, your balance doesn't matter. As long as it's not over your head, the water will keep you up. And you can do that, or you can do yoga, both of which you can do, and the reward will be, I think, a large improvement on the quality of life.
Let me ask you a question. Overall life advice to people you know and people you've never met ever in your life that are looking at you, okay? They see me, but they look at you because you're more of an inspiration than me because you actually have MS. How do you tell them to wake up every day? What's your advice and try and believe? What would your advice be?
To look at what you can do that you enjoy doing, whether it's sitting in a chair and stretching, or whether it's running or swimming, whatever you can do, do it and forgive yourself. Don't blame yourself. This is not your fault. And
if you have MS, is it over?
Absolutely not. It is absolutely not over. In fact, it might be an opportunity. In my case, I was one of those women that was driven. I mean, I was a single mother with him. I probably would have worked myself into dying of a heart attack. But MS stopped me. I had to learn to pace myself. It was a lesson. It was a valuable lesson. So it can be a gift. It can be a gift. and take the support, reach out and take the support that's out there. And one of the major lessons that I learned is you have to learn how to ask for help.
This is a woman.
You're so inspiring.
When I say she's my superwoman, this is a woman that wanted to save the world, wants to save the world, wanted to help people, wanted to educate people, wanted to tutor everybody in math because she was a math major. My worst class was math, and I didn't need to come home to my math major mom, you know, and she'd say, do your best. And I was like, I did do my best. She's like, a C plus is not your best. And so my point is, this is a woman who I watched want to save the world and the people around her because she was this rock. And as she just said, I was like, Mom, you did your time. Now you got to take care of yourself. And if you do the best that you can do, and you've given me this life, and you've blessed me with these values, and I have these opportunities because of you, now let me help you. So sit your butt down and let me help you out.
Thank you so much. We're so honored to be here tonight. And thank you again for having us. Thank you, Shamar. Thank you.